All right. Welcome back to daily update my 1000 day challenge. This is day 490. So it's almost halfway into the challenge itself. So I wouldn't say the challenge is going on bad, but you can look at it. I've only progressed 50% from where I've been, and it's almost close to 500 days itself. So it's been really quite long. I wouldn't say the progress is bad, but I wouldn't say the progress is good as well. So right now the market has been so-called flatlining for the past been a couple of months, going up, going down. So I haven't been making such a good progress like what I've experienced earlier in the year itself. But bearing in mind that earlier in the year, we do have a very strong bullish market. So that's something I'm still trying to refine along the way, improving the strategies, both in terms of the strategy itself and also in terms of the risk management itself. So that's something I've been tweaking along the way. Other than that, if you're looking in terms of the general market update itself, the S&P or US market itself looks to have a pullback in place. And right now we do see we have the first line of support. So potentially I will consider adding in small position, perhaps like 10% of the full allocation that I do intend to allocate during this period of time, because I do see potential for the downside. But of course, we could also consolidate and move towards the upside. So ASHR looks to be relatively flat. On the other hand, KWEB, because I guess of the recent news of how DD is going to delist from the US market itself, it does spark some fears, especially towards tech stocks related in the US market, be it Alibaba, Tencent, or even JD.com, etc. So if you're a little bit more cautious, do considering them selling it out and actually buying them in the Hong Kong market itself, there will be perhaps your safer bet. But bear in mind that I still do see long-term potential for these China tech firms in that sense. But of course, bear in mind that I do have to consider that they have to be greater discounted simply because of the way capitalism works is very different in China, whereby they follow more of a socialism kind of a concept. Not to say that it's better or not to say that it's bad, I would say that's just different. So bearing in mind that that kind of a value has to be put into consideration. And moreover, with the new generation of people putting in the money, it will also be something that you have to take note of. So that will cause a difference in terms of the valuation itself. All right, so otherwise, that's more or less about it. In terms of Bitcoin-wise, I don't see any potential trade setup, say on a forward chart. You can see over here, we are still trending very nicely above these 50 simple moving average and 20 exponential moving average itself. So if we do break towards upside, there'll be a very good sign because we're actually consolidating right below the key resistance at 200 exponential moving average itself. But of course, we can also break towards the downside, in which case there'll be a really bearish move, bearing in mind that we are still clearly forming lower highs and lower low as of this moment in time. But if we do break above that, then this key resistance area will be break upon together with this 200 exponential moving average on the forward chart. And with that said, I've come to the end of today, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.